Welcome back to my channel. It's Noob. Today we're going to code a new problem. That problem name is Armstrong number. Armstrong number. I hope you guys know about what is Armstrong number. If you don't know about or what is Armstrong, so don't worry about it. I'm going to teach you what is Armstrong number. Then after we switch to coding part. Let's suppose we have 153 number. We have a 3-digit number. The number is 153. When you one cross one. When you 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. When add this number and the sum of these cube is equal to actual of that number, then that number is called to be Armstrong number. Let's take example here, taking a 153. Now taking individual numbers 1 cube of 1 plus cube of 5. So I'm not unable to use the cube symbol, so I'm just multiplying by 3 times for just expressing the cubic form. So 5 star 5 star 5 plus 3 star 3 star 3. So what do we get? We get 1 plus 5 cube means 125 plus 3 cube means 9 9 27. When add this number, what we get? Here we get 126 plus 27. When we add this number, what we get? 153. Here you can see, here is 153 also, and its cubic sum is also comes 153. So this number is Armstrong number. Take one another example, 1 2 3. So just break this number into 3 parts. Here we taking separately 1 2 and 3. Now we again making this number cubic, and after making this number cubic, then we add these numbers individually. Here 1 cube is what? 1 cube is what? 1. 2 cube is what? 3. 2 cube is what? 8. And 3 cube is what? 27. When we add this number, what we get? 9. 9 plus 27 is what? 36. So 36 is not equal to 123. So if this number is not an Armstrong number, I hope guys you will understand what is Armstrong number. Let's move to the coding part, where we're going to code this problem. Let's open the code blocks. Let's open the code blocks where we code this. For this problem, have just take a number from user and take some if and r in and just copy p is equal to n. And while p is greater than 0, sum is equal to sum plus r cross. So p cross. Now first of all, we have to store the number r. R is equal to P modulus N. N R cross R cross R. And again we divide the number, T divide is equal to 10. Now check condition, if T and sorry sum is equal to T N, then see how is a Armstrong number. Else layout, else layout. Armstrong number. Let's run it, our code. Yes, so if you run it and compile it, let's check 153 is Armstrong or not. It is Armstrong number. Guys, we have successfully write this code for the Armstrong problem. Let's check for one. We are also taking 123. Check it is Armstrong or not. 123. It is not Armstrong number. I hope guys you will understand what is Armstrong number. Let's don't waste the time. Let's retest the code. Here I am checking n is equal to 153. Here I am declaring four variables. Just getting this variable, just message, just knowing this variable, and just for the n we see in for getting the input from the user, we get the user. We get the 153 from the user and we store into n. Now we another make a copy of n into temp variable, so we just store the temp is equal to 153. Now again taking t is greater than 0, so t is what 153 greater than 0. Yes, r is what 153 modulus 10. What we get? 3. Okay, now sum, initially sum is equal to 0. Okay, I'm not assigning, but we just assign it. It is 0. Now sum is 0. So sum plus 3 cross 3 cross 3. What we get? We get 27. Now sum is equal to 27. Okay. Now again t divided by 10, so t is what 153 is divided by 10, but we get 15. 15 is greater than 0. Yes, again we come under the while loop. R is now we again storing the r value. Now t is 15. Now 15 modulus 10, what we get? 15 modulus 10 we get 5. Now just cube it, make it cube because here is cube. What we get? 125. Initially sum 125. Initially sum is 27. Just add it 125. Now again divide the t. T is 15. Then we divide 15 by 10. What we get? 1. We get 1. Again check t is greater than 0. Yes, condition true. Again we are storing the r value by modulus, was taking the modulus of t is what? 1 modulus 10. We get 1. And again make it cube because here it is r cube, so make it cube. What we get? 1. Add into sum is 27. 125 plus 1. and we add, what we get 153. Now t is what, 0, because there is no any number is left for dividing. So it is, suppose it is 0. 0 divided by 10, what we get? 0. 0 is greater than 0. Condition false. It comes to here if condition to check whether the sum is equal to n or not. Sum is 153 and n is what? 153. Both are equal. Yes. Yes, both are equal. So it prints it is an Armstrong number. Otherwise, if it is not equal, then it is a not Armstrong number. I hope guys you will understand. Again, revise it by writing this code on the paper, and please retest this code by onself. Because when you watching this video, you will getting all this thing. When you try to retest this code by yourself, on that time you just stuck on so many problems. When you practicing this code after too many times, then definitely you will be get a better solution and a better understanding. So I hope you will understand this video. Stay healthy, stay safe, peace.